Today we are talking about plagiarism, and this video is for PhD or research students, scientists, lecturers and assistant professors who want to publish their work. In this video, I'm going to show you only three slides, but my suggestion is that you watch this video till the end, otherwise you might miss some important information. And what are these three slides? First, I will show you why you should avoid plagiarism. Then I will describe five different forms of plagiarism which you may not know before. And then when it comes to checking the plagiarism, there are a lot of software available and students are confused which software to use or not. I am not going to recommend any software. I will just mention few, but I will give you a method, a criteria which you can use to evaluate any software whether or not you should use that software to check the plagiarism. Now another question is, if you are not copying someone else's work, why you should bother checking your paper before submission? And the reason is that even if coincidentally your one sentence is matching with someone else's work, it is still considered as plagiarism, because publishing houses, they are becoming strict and strict every single day. They can tolerate one or two words matching, up to three or four. But if a complete sentence is matching with some other research paper or on some other website, then you are in trouble. So watch this video full, and I am confident that you will get some value. And we are starting right after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. And now without further ado, I will jump on my computer and I will show you my three slides. In this video, we will talk about plagiarism. The first question you might ask, why should you avoid plagiarism? I have mentioned three very simple reasons here. The first is that it is easy to detect plagiarism. Now, you cannot just put something copy and paste from some other resource without citing and hope that nobody will detect. No, it's not possible now. The algorithms, the software is so advanced that it will easily detect the plagiarism. In particular, the software used by the editors of large publishing houses such as IEEE, ProQuest, Science Direct. So they are so advanced. They can detect one word, two word, three word, four word matching. And up to three or four word, they might tolerate you. But if five or six words of your article are matched with any previously published article, it is clearly plagiarism. And if there is one complete sentence, for sure it's plagiarism. And then these publishing houses will prohibit you from publishing on their platform, and you can destroy your reputation and even your career. And if you look at any of the platforms, they have lists of authors who have been prohibited from publishing on those publishers. Like IEEE, anybody can search if you are prohibited or not, and then nobody will ever accept your paper. So there is no need to lecture any PhD student on this topic. It's very straightforward that you always must use your own ideas, your own words, and your own explanation. Now, in this video, I have put only three slides, because for a wise person, this information is enough. And if you still want to try and hope, then it's up to you. Now, before I tell you how to avoid plagiarism, what are a few things, because there is a chance that it's a coincidence that one of your sentences matches with someone else. So there are a few things which you can do about this before submitting your paper. So that is in the third slide. But first, let's have a look at what are various forms of plagiarism. So the first thing is very obvious, exact copy from a source without citing. The second reason is exact copy from few different sources and citing few of them, but not citing all of them. You must cite all the sources from where you are copying anything in your manuscript. Now, the third reason is wrong citations are citations to sources not available anywhere. So you cannot trick the system. You cannot put some wrong citations and then try to get some credit for that thing. So always make sure that your citations are correct. Even mistakes are not allowed.
You cannot say later on, oh, sorry, it was a mistake. Now, number four, citing all sources properly, but absence of any original contribution. You cannot do this, that you put some very valuable information from few sources and make a paragraph or make a page and there is nothing of your own work. All is copy and pasted from other sources. That is also a plagiarism, because you are not putting forward anything from your own efforts. You are just copy and pasting. Then why you are submitting that thing? If the only material in your document, in your paper, is copy and pasted from other sources, then why, what are you presenting? If you are in this situation, so then what it means? It means that you are trying to put forward work from other people and trying to prove that this is your work, this is your paper. How can you do that? It is clear plagiarism. So you must have some original contribution in your paper. Number five, replacing few words here and there, but keeping the essence of someone else's work. The original work is from someone. You are just trying to make few sentences by replacing the words. This can be easily detected by modern software. So you cannot get away with this. Don't do this. So these are some of the forms of plagiarism. And if you search on the web, you will find some other explanations a little bit more in detail. Now the last and the most important slide, how to avoid plagiarism. Well, there are only two things you can do. The first thing is by not copying any material in your manuscript without citing. As I mentioned earlier, just one sentence and you are gone. It's plagiarism. And the second thing is by checking your manuscript before submission for coincidental match. You might put a very short sentence and someone might have already used that sentence. So this is the thing I can imagine, that there might be some coincidental matching. So for that, you can check your manuscript before submission. Now you can use any of the software which I have mentioned here at the end, few of them, but I have few points for you which I have mentioned here. So these points are very important for you to understand, that every software claims that they have millions and billions of papers in their database. Don't trust anyone. Okay, the simple thing you can do is you can see who are their partners. They have a list of publishers which are partner with that particular software. You just look at their partners and then go to that publisher website, the major publishers like IEEE and ProQuest and Science Direct and all these. And those publishers normally are trustworthy organizations. So see how many articles they have, how many articles are in their database. And then you can ask them that whether you are partnered with this particular software or not. Because if software is unable to detect your manuscript, you are using a free software or something like that, that is not enough. Because free software, number one, they don't have a big database. And number two, the problem is you can only check maybe 1,000 words or 1,500 words. Then you have to check again and again, again and again. So it's very hard. So your university might have some software where you can check, or ask your supervisor. He might have some subscription or something. So check on a good software. So don't trust the software if they say that they have millions and billions of paper. See the list of their partners and try to verify how much they might have. Then the second thing is that whether the software is capable of checking the domains, like the material on the website. This is also important. And the third thing is that what are other features available in that plagiarism checker? For example, whether it can check a 25,000 word document simultaneously, whether it can check on 2-word, 3-word, 4-word basis, or what? How? What are the features? Now, I have mentioned three options here. It doesn't mean that I have used all these. I have just used Grammarly and I am not very happy with that, but it's okay. I now don't use even Grammarly. I just used it for some period of time, but it was okay. But I don't think it's very sophisticated. So another option I got on the web was Crossref. I never used it. You can see and have a look. Similarly, Copyscape has a good reputation. So these are the three options which have good reputation, but you have to check on your own, because only you are responsible for your manuscript. So this is it about plagiarism. I hope that you will take it very seriously.
So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and see you next time.